Yo, what's going on, Dragon Ballers? Welcome back to another video. Today we're talking about 10 more cards in set 13 that actually boost older archetypes. Today's video will be more focused on the TP cards coming out. There's actually a lot of TPs in the set that focus on older strategies, which it's not like it's unseen in any other set, but it's definitely a very high degree in the set. There are a ton of TPs actually, to the point where like a lot of the archetypes in set 13 actually kind of got shafted and don't get any TP support. It's a little bit weird, but we'll talk about them. We'll talk about how they kind of fit in older strategies. If you're new here, guys, definitely subscribe. Hit that bell so you don't miss a video. If you guys want to help support the channel and you want to buy any of the cards you see in today's video or any Dragon Ball Super cards for that matter, go down in the description. Use my link to TCG Player. It does help the channel out a lot. That being said, let's get started. We'll start with a non-TP card. We have King Piccolo, the next step to you. So this is a one-drop common coming out in the set. It is actually King Piccolo support. We all know King Piccolo is doing ridiculously good in the meta right now. So let's see what kind of support they're getting. Activate main once per turn, pay a red. If you don't have a red unison card in play, choose one of the Piccolo Jr. unisons in your hand or face up in your life and play it with a marker on it. This is pretty nice, I guess. I think you have to play it for one. I don't really think there's a way to cheat this guy into play. So essentially for one energy, maybe on one or maybe on two, and then for additional energy, you put Piccolo Jr. into play with one marker, and then you can uptick it up to two. And then you have the activate battle. If your leaders are red King Piccolo card and you have red Namekian or Demon Clan cards face up in your life, add top card of deck to life, then use one red Namekian or Demon Clan card face up in your life in a combo, then negate the scope for the game. So essentially once per game, per copy of the card, you get an additional leader skill. So I can definitely see how this card adds value to the deck. I think the activate main to play a unison is just a little bit weird. Like, it seems kind of neat if you get stuck with it in your life. That could definitely be a thing. But yeah, besides that, I think the activate battle of, you know, basically being a secondary leader effect is really good. Then we got Android 16, Stalwart Defender. We have a 5-drop blue-green energy exhaust, a rival blue-green for blue. So keep in mind, in the Android 16 leader, energy exhaust will be negated here. Auto when this card's played, you can't play copies of this card for the turn, then choose one effect. Choose one of your opponent's battle cards, then it costs a 4 or less and KO it. Or if your leader is a blue Android card, add up to one blue Android 16 card, then it costs a 2 or less from your deck to your hand, then shuffle your deck. So this is like a pseudo turn one play in like Android 21 or Android 16, for instance, where you could either search for Android 16 energy amplification or the new one drop Android 16 from Evolution Booster that like spawns extra tokens to your opponent's field. I think that actually searching energy amplification is quite good. The only kind of awkward thing is like to actually play this on turn one, you do need a blue green arrival. So like probably like a Bionic Blitz super combo, which isn't impossible. You're most likely playing 4 copies of that card in a 21 or 16 deck, but it's just a little bit weird that, you know, this, the way it curves is just weird because you want to play this for one on one. In 16, you can always charge untapped usually. In 21, you can do it too. If you draw the 17 check land, the super 17 check land rather, you can do it. It just curves a bit weird because reliant on arrival, but maybe even defensively on your opponent's first or second turn while you have one open energy in 21, you could just like combo Bionic Blitz, arrive this, search energy amplification, play it on your turn two. I can see that being pretty cool in the deck. So I like this card a little bit. Not too in love with it, but it's neat. Nova Shenron, Unwavering Conviction. We have 4-drop 20k for the Sin Shenron archetype. Critical blocker, auto burst one. If your leader card and energy are all yellow, so keep in mind not mono yellow, so like a blue yellow deck, for instance, could use this. When this card is using the combo from your hand, choose up to one of your opponent's battle cards or unison cards and switch it to rest mode. This is interesting. This is almost like Power of a Super Saiyan, which is a super rare coming out in set 13 that almost pretty much does the same thing, except it like draws a card and can be used free. This just seems like a worse version of that. It's honestly pretty weird. It's kind of neat how in like Sin you could play this with your leader ulti. That's like a thing. I don't think you could play this off of a Nova Shenron, the 4-drop SR Nova Shenron. I don't think you could play this off of that. I think that card has like a power level restriction, if I'm not mistaken. If you can play this off Nova Shenron, that's pretty cool. But yeah, the comboing effect just doesn't seem as good as Power of a Super Saiyan, so it's a little bit weird to me. Just my kind of thoughts on that. Then we got Goku Black Time Ring Trespass. We have a 4-drop yellow unison. So right off the bat, you're thinking Sin Shenron. I can play this in Sin Shenron and I can awaken with it. As at the moment, before this card releases, there's only one unison you can play in the Sin deck to get awakened. That's Makiki Gabora 4-drop. Excellent, excellent unison. Super good. But this one actually has an activate main where you can play it for 3. So if your leader card and energy are all mono yellow, you can play it from your hand with 3 markers. So Sin can get awakened on turn 3. Might be okay for like the Sin aggro decks, but even at the same time, I think you want to use your energy on turn 3 for other things besides your unison. there are so many cards in Sin that take life now that I don't think you really need to play Unison on 3 to awaken. You should be able to get there through other effects. Auto for a plus or minus 0. At the end of your turn, switch this card to active mode to gain blocker until the end of your opponent's next turn. So that's really just like in theme with the mid-range slash control stuff. This isn't really helping the aggro deck. Activate main minus 1. Choose one of your opponent's battle cards in rest mode. Negate its skills for the turn and KO it. I really think overall this is just worse than Makiki Bora. Like, if you're playing the control mid-range version of Sin, I think Makiki Bora is better than this. Yeah, this comes out a turn earlier, but it doesn't even have a plus 1. So, honestly, in my opinion, not the best, even though it probably is made directly for Sin Shenron. Then we got Pan Heroine's Lineage. This is basically a really old school free blocker. If you have a Goku GT or a Heroine card in your leader battle area, you can play it for free, and it's a blocker. It's okay. It's another interesting tool you can use in the Heroine archetype. I don't think it's going to be like incredible for any Lineage strategy because you're probably not playing the Goku GT leader. You're probably going to play the Goku Junior leader because just is way more than any other Lineage leader in the game when it comes out. The Heroine thing, again, it's cool. Gives you some access to yellow. I don't think there were a ton of yellow Heroine cards revealed in Evolution Booster. So, not the worst, not the best. Pretty much like a down-the-middle card for me. Chi-Lai Behind the Scenes Heroine. We have a 1-drop 5k. When this card's played from your hand, draw one card. If your leader is a Heroine card, negate this card's skills for the game. So, upon first read, this effect is actually very, very weird. But it actually has a little bit of like hidden synergy with Great Saiyan Man 2 from Draft Box 6. That card is a Videl, so it counts as a Heroine. It's a green card. Basically, what it does is you can bounce a skillless card back to your hand and play it for one, and then you can, you know, do another effect to play a skillless from the deck. So this actually being a one-drop Heroine that you can play a draw and then do that combo is actually kind of neat for Heroine. So that is like a pretty cool piece of tech for the deck. I don't think that's gonna like put Heroine over the top or anything, but I do think it's a step in the right direction for the archetype. Then we got Turles leading the core. We have 4-drop 15k unique EX evolve over a green Turles with a cost of 3 or less. When this card's played, switch to active mode, then add up to 1 fruit of the Tree of Might from your deck to hand, then shuffle your deck. Auto, if it's your opponent's turn and one of your green Turles Crusher Core cards is played in rest mode, choose that card and switch it to active mode. This is interesting. So you can evolve this over 3-drop Turles. The 3-drop, like, quote-unquote arrival Turles is one of the best cards in the deck, so that's really good. You get to add a fruit, not bad. And then during your opponent's turn, when you basically, like, quote-unquote arrive your Crusher Core cards, basically by just, like, comboing them into play, they come in active mode, so they're usable again for another combo during the next battle, which is kind of nice, because, like, when you would combo your Diaz and your other guys that aren't one of the Raisin Brothers, when you would combo them, they would come and rest, and, like, you couldn't really use them until your next turn. But now with this guy, that kind of fixes that problem. The blocker Raisin Brother already came in active mode, so that's not too much of a problem. This card's weird. It's okay. Again, not, like, incredible. It doesn't have protection, so being a 4-drop without unique or deflect, even though you can play it for technically 0... a bit weird. I think maybe Turles play maybe 2, maybe 3 copies of this card, but it definitely doesn't like make the archetype super broken. It's just a decent piece of support for it. Gogeta Effortless Strike. We have a 5-drop 15k unique blocker. Auto, and one of your blue Gogeta cards with an energy cost of 5 or more other than copies of this card is removed from your battle area by an opponent's skill. Play this card from your hand. Activate main for a blue. If your opponent has 3 or more energy and you place 1 blue Goku with energy cost of 1 and 1 blue Vegeta card with energy cost of 1 from your drop to the bottom of your deck in any order, play this card from your hand. So essentially a really cheap way to get a Gogeta into play in the PyCon strategy from the looks of it. I guess you can play this in just about any other blue deck that is able to play the Gogeta stuff, but a lot of that newer Gogeta stuff, like the new 8-drop, well, the new 8-drop's not really tied to PyCon, but the 5-drop from set 12 is tied to PyCon. So this seems like it'll synergize best in the PyCon deck, but technically, if you're playing 1-drop Gokus and Vegetas in any strategy, you should be able to play this and then evolve into your 8-drop Gogeta, the one they basically made to replace Gogeta 7 Hero Revive. So pretty cool, not bad. It does come out for cheap. It's a 1-drop blocker at the worst. At the best, comes in for free, and then you can evolve on top of it. Definitely not a bad card. Pincer Attack Android 18. Got a 2-drop 15k. Auto, if your leader card is a blue Android 18 and you choose one of your opponent's clone tokens and remove it from the game, when this card is using a combo from your hand, add up to 1 Supreme Technique Krillin from your deck to your hand, then shuffle your deck. So Supreme Technique Krillin is actually a in-archetype Champa for the Android 18 clone token deck. So being able to search that is definitely not bad. You combo this, you add that right to your hand, and then if your leader effect's active, that actually becomes a free combo because I think it's a base 1 energy 5k combo. So you do that, and you basically get a free large amount of combo power plus a double strike right there. auto for a blue. If your leader is a blue Android 18 card at the end of a battle, which is cards used in a combo from your hand, play this card from your drop area. So furthermore, comes into play as a 15k attacker. Pretty cool for tempo. Like you're going with that big leader effect. Give me the double strike with the Krillin, and then you're getting another 15k attacker on top of that. Definitely not a bad card. Android 18 definitely been one of the under-supported archetypes, especially when compared to 21, which is like the clone token queen, right? So I think these cards are all pretty cool. Some of them definitely worse and better than others. But again, it's really weird that like there's so much support in the TPs here that are going to older strategies rather than like the set 13 decks. Like King Cole didn't get much or anything, actually. It's kind of weird that some of the set 13 decks didn't really get any love. So just my thoughts, guys. Hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.